across the entire state are still waiting to learn whether documents with details of the case against Delphi murder suspect Richard Allen will soon be released. Thanks so much for joining us tonight, live at 5. I'm Dan Spieler.
And I'm Birshel Edme. Special Judge Fran Gull of Fort Wayne will hear arguments for and against the release of the probable cause affidavit. That's happening next week. And those documents will detail some of the evidence and the reason, perhaps, behind Allen's arrest.
Fox 59's Russ McQuaid joins us live in the newsroom with a look at what we can expect next week and why this is so pivotal, Russ.
And good afternoon, Dan. When a judge issued these orders this week, appointing two attorneys to defend Delphi murder suspect Richard Allen, it set the stage for next Tuesday's hearing.
We've never seen Richard Allen in public or heard someone read the charges against him because on October 28th, 2 days after he was arrested, Allen's initial hearing was held without notice inside the Carroll County Courthouse and the probable cause affidavit was sealed.
It'd have to be for substantial cause and, like I said, it would have to be of a very limited duration.
That duration may be up Tuesday when Allen County Superior Court Special Judge Fran Gull drives over from Fort Wayne to preside over the hearing when Carroll County Prosecutor Nicholas McLellan can make his best pitch to keep the PC sealed or release it with certain redactions. With it being sealed, Judge Dan Henke, who is not affiliated with the trial, says Allen himself may not even know the full extent of the case.
He has a right to know the nature of the charges against him.
Indiana State Police Superintendent Doug Carter says the release of the documents won't affect the case against Allen. If released, the probable cause could explain why detectives recently came back to take a second look at Allen. As I previously reported, he was interviewed as an initial witness in 2017 when he admitted being on the bridge the day Libby and Abby were killed. It could also indicate whether investigators think Allen is the man on the bridge captured on Libby's cell phone, or if he played a role in the killings, or if evidence found in his home connects him to the crime scene.
When a year down the road you find out, oops, we just found out he was there at the time and he is involved. So you have to add that back to your investigation, and it's almost like restarting the whole thing again.
Judge Henke told me it's possible the prosecutors or defense attorneys could request Judge Gull to issue a gag order to keep anyone connected with the criminal trial from talking to reporters for the months or years it will take for this case to move to a conclusion. We've been told Judge Gull is inclined to release the PC pending those arguments next Tuesday. In the newsroom, Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.